Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nidjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm rendering exposition of John 12, verse 32 onward. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself. That means Christ Jesus was anointed Son of God. And he came here to make us equal to him. That is why at the end Jesus was calling his brethren, who were laborers with him, friends. Friend has a higher status than brethren. Friend means that they have compatible with him in all aspects. So he also made them the sons of the Most High. So Jesus himself was Son of the Most High, anointed one, and he made his laborers the Son of the Most High too. He said this to show by what kind of death he was going to die. The people of conscience after the death of Jesus deserted the temple and their priest, rabbi priest. But they deserted the rabbi priest, but the rabbi priest, you know, put on these dog collar, and they entered into the church with Torah under their armpit, and they soon recaptured them. And as stated in Matthew 12, verse 43-45, and when they recaptured them, the situation became worse than before the arrival of Jesus. So temple priests start killing the people, and they bound them tightly, as Pope did, you know. Anybody who spoke against the Pope, he was killed or put at stake. So they killed the spirit of the people. So the crowd answered him, "We have heard from the law in the scripture," you know, that because the root of the scripture is his word, which is Christ, that the Christ remains forever. Remember that Moses put on Christ and wrote Torah. So without Christ, you cannot write even scripture. So Jesus defined a moral teacher or a rabbi in Matthew 13, verse 52. He is like the owner of a house, which is synagogue, who brings out treasures old and new. The old are the scriptures which are written, passed on from generation to generation. And the new are his word, oral Torah. So when they became greedy, the knowledge of oral Torah was lost, because God, oral Torah comes from God, his word. So when you love mammon, you can't have his word. So they became hypocrite, you know. So the Christ was in the beginning. Christ stands for his word. It is before the creation. Before Yahweh, before Abraham, before Adam. Forever. This is well said, you know. If you understand this one, then you will see how spiritually blind these clerics are. They are working for mammon, not for God. How can you say that the Son of Man must be lifted up? The Jews asked him, you know. Who is this Son of Man? the Son of Man, is the Son of Yahweh, the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam, Jesus, not Christ. Jesus was the name of his physical body that was born and that died. That is related to Son of Man. Christ is related to Son of God. God is spirit, man is flesh. Christ stands for his word and is a title. This people understand, you know, that Christ is a title, never born and never died. A doctor is never born and he never dies. A university professor, never born, never died. So it's wrong to say on the death of a person, oh, such a university professor died. No, it was his secular name that died. Christ was before the creation and he is forever. But the dog-collared people in the Nicene Creed kill Christ. If you see the Nicene Creed, they say Christ died, Christ rose on third day, which is nonsense. Jesus died, Jesus rose on third day. There was a priest in Reading Church who altered this place thing, you know. He put down Jesus died and Jesus rose on third day. When I went to see that Nicene Creed, you know, there, I was very pleased that this man has common sense. So he came to my house to discuss, you know. But when I started to tell him more, oh, he wouldn't agree. This is written in our Bible, this and that, you know. He was going by what is written and not want to think logically. So I left him there. So in this case, they say they kill Christ, and at Easter proclaim that Christ instead of Jesus has risen. They say Christ has risen, but in fact it was Jesus who was risen, you know. So Jesus said to them, the light is among you for a little while longer. So Christ Jesus has given us the light, you know, by this gospel. It is up to us to have it or reject it. Many people, you know, they understand what is written. But when their priest, you know, give them a sermon, which is sugar-coated, they believe the priest. They don't raise their voice. Hey, how can you say that? This is wrong what you are saying. No, they won't say. They will keep quiet, you know. So when they keep quiet, they get double guilty. They are twice guilty, you know. People who did not understand, they are less guilty. So they will suffer more during that riots or Holocaust than people who did not understand the what is right or wrong. Walk while you have the light, lest darkness overtake you. So far the light, and join me and walk with me. The one who walks in the darkness does not know where he is going. That is the once born people, you know, who have no knowledge. As people going to churches, they are devoted to Christ Jesus, but they will say prayer. But there's a person who is twice born. He knows that prayer is wrong, antichrist, because this is the temple of God, and before the things come on from my mouth at the lips, your first prayer, he has already heard me. So he knows from my heart what is in my, what I am going to say. So it's no good to say blah, 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 this and that, you know. It is, the prayer used to be a way of communication to Yahweh in the old system. But Yahweh is a demiurge God. He is not real. That's why he was kept alienated. Our Father is real. He is living in us, living temple of God which we are carrying. So he does not need prayer. He needs exposition of his word as a way of communication. So prayer has been replaced by exposition of his word. While you have light, believe in the light, that you may become sons of light, sons of the Most High. When Jesus had said these things, he departed and hid himself from them, though he had done so many signs before them, they still did not believe in him. So you can see, you know, nature of the people, because they were stooges of the temple priest. To temple priests, they have given their heart and not to God. Like people listening to Pope. And if I tell them Pope is Antichrist, they would not believe me. They may even beat me. But fortunately in the West, you know, people are not that stupid. They have common sense. They listen to you. So the people still, you know, were believing in their temple priests and rabbis. So that the words spoken by the prophet Isaiah might be fulfilled. Father and not the Lord, you know, Yahweh. Yahweh is the Lord, you know, we don't have Lord in our, in Christianity or in Jesus. We have Father and our Mother is Holy Spirit and Son, which is we are. Father, who has believed what he heard from us, to whom has the arm of the Father been revealed? That means by the grace of our Father, this is the arm of the Father. His word is the arm. Arm is the one which you use to do the work, to defend yourself also. So, this is our shield, sword, double-edged sword, which Jesus has given to us. And if we use it, we attain salvation. Therefore, they could not believe. For again, Isaiah said, he has blinded their eyes. They saw the resurrection of Lazarus. They saw how the people were cured and how the dead were made alive. But they still did not believe. But whatever the rabbi told them, temple high priest told them, they believed him. They too told him that, oh, he's a magician, you know. He's a magic man who is making dead people alive and all that. They believed in him, not what they saw. So such people are, many people are in this world now, as Pope has so many following. All of them believe like that. People believed in temple high priest. He has blinded their eyes and hardened their heart, lest they see with their eyes and understand with their heart. The Christianity is of the heart, not of the book. That is why Jesus said, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus, which is gospel or his word preached by Jesus, We hear it with our ears. Ear is the mouth. We take it to our heart, digest it, and then after understanding it, we preach it from our own mouth in honor of Jesus, because we are the virgin bride of our bridegroom is Christ Jesus, to glorify our Father. And understand with the heart and tongue, and I would heal them. That means I will give them salvation, you know, will be obtained. Isaiah said these things because he saw his glory, because he knew the glory of Christ. He knew what Christ looks like and how people will behave under their temple high priest, and spoke of him and spoke of Christ Jesus. People believed their temple high priest, as today people believe Antichrist Pope. So whatever Antichrist Pope tells them, they believe. They don't have their own logical reasoning or common sense. Common sense is Holy Spirit. Nevertheless, many even of the authorities believed in him. But for fear of the Pharisees, they did not confess it, so that they would not be put out of the synagogue. So that is the reason, you know, in the synagogue they were sitting with their shawl and other thing. As you see in some churches, there's a church in Reading called Church of Brethren, and they have a special dress, black pant and white shirt. And so the ladies also have white dress, as if they are the virgin brides of Christ Jesus. Now I wanted to go there, you know, and a colleague invited me, come to our church. I said, okay, I will go. I could not find the church, you know, but he gave me the number of the church. It was, I rang the one of their elders in the church. Oh, you can't come to our church unless we vet you. We see what they, I said, okay. Then three of them, you know, were gathered together and they invited me, come. I went there and they were talking Jesus as Lord and God. I told them, no, we have one Father. In Christianity, there is no Lord. Lords have slave. Father has sons. So we have Father, you know, and Mother is Holy Spirit. And they said, no, this is not our belief. Our beliefs are written in the church constitution. We believe Jesus is the Lord, and God is Lord and all that, you know. I said, no, sorry, I don't believe in that. Oh, then you can't come to our church. That's it. So they were very proud, you know, because of that white uniform and all that. As you see some churches in Nigeria and other places, where the women have special dress singing. And those people, you know, when they sing, go there to sing, they are stiff-necked. They are very proud that we have been chosen, you know. Same these Jewish people. They were very proud sitting in the synagogue. And they were hating Gentile. Gentile have nothing. We have shawl. We have Torah. They have nothing. So this way they were proud, you know. So that's why Jesus, as soon as he healed the sick people, your Jewish sick people of leprosy, he healed 10 of them, and one of them was a Gentile. All the 9, as soon as they were healed, they ran to their rabbi to pay him the homage, present, and then sat in the synagogue became his stooges, stooge, leaving Christ Jesus alone. Whereas the Gentile, when he was healed, he accompanied Jesus. He appreciated. So we need people like Gentile, but the Messianic Jews, on occupying the church, they killed the Gentile apostles. The Gentile apostles, they opened monasteries and all that. Still, they killed them by putting them before the animals or by stake and so and so. So they hate them too much, but they suffer too. For they love the glory that comes from man more than the glory that comes from our Father God. That means they were not solitary. Because they dare not to be solitary and wanted to share their ego of being a Jew superior to the Gentiles. So they went there, you know. So those who understood the message but did not put it into practice are more guilty than the people who did not understand the message, or the simpletons. So people who are, that's why Jesus, you know, when Stephen was stoned to death, Stephen said, Father, forgive them, they don't know what they are doing. So they are the once born people, you know, stooges of the temple priest. But those who understood it, but still they did not act, you know, went back to the temples, synagogue, to become the stooges of the temple priest, they are double guilty. That's why when Jesus was crucified, he was beaten badly. And Jesus could carry the cross himself, but he pretended that he can't carry it. He wanted to see if there is any person in Jerusalem who can come forward to help him carry the cross. None of them turned up because of the stern eye of the temple high priest. A village man from far away, he came and helped him. He wasn't afraid of the temple priest. So much more can be told, but its gospel is preached face to face, not like this.